7 years ago, when I started my dreadlock journey, there were a lot of ups and downs that I endured. It was a lot of mistakes, a lot of setbacks, a lot of frustrations that I just had to overcome and learn from because of the lack of knowledge that I had when it came to dreadlocks. You see, 7 years ago, there weren't a lot of dreadlock YouTube videos out there. And the ones that were out there, there were a lot of women doing it. Now, don't get me wrong, I did watch a lot of women videos, especially the dreadlock shampoo videos. When they would show you how to wash their dreadlocks, they'd be in the shower and stuff. My bad. Now, me personally, I wanted a YouTuber who looked like me, you know, who's a guy. That's pretty obvious. I wanted to hear a man's opinion and a man's perspective of how they went through their dreadlock journey. Now, because of my own lack of knowledge and because of my ignorance, I went through dreadlock hell. But what I want to give you guys are 5 mistakes that I personally went through, so you guys won't have to go through them. And with those mistakes, I'm going to actually explain to you guys how to avoid it. And I'm going to also give you guys 5 seconds to hit the like button. Thank you. I think that was like 6 seconds, but you know, doesn't matter because now we're about to hit the intro. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. My name is Vinny Matthews. And before I start the video, where are all my dreadheads at? If you have dreads, if you're about to start your dreadlock journey, if you're in the middle of your dreadlock journey, if you're 18 years in your dreadlock journey, follow my Instagram right now. Send me some pictures of your locks. I want to give back to my subscribers. I want to review your locks. I want to put you on my channel. I want to check out your locks, man. Let's just have some fun with it. So go to my Instagram right now. Send me 3, 4, 5 photos. It doesn't matter. Send me some photos of your locks. Maybe even send a video. I would love it if you send me a video. Send me a video. Man, even yo, if you want to, yo, you can do a shout out. Do a shout out to whoever, your loctician, your mom, your girlfriend, your side girl. It doesn't matter. Just follow my Instagram right now. Send me your photos. And yo, in the next week or so, we will make a review of your dreadlocks. I want to review all my subscribers' dreadlocks. Let me know. I can give you some advice. You can give me some advice. And let's just have some fun with it. So go ahead and hit the like button because we're about to get into the video. Subscribe to the channel. Let's get right into it. Now, the first mistake that I went through when it came to my dreadlock journey was not understanding the dreadlock process. When I think about dreadlocks now, I say to myself, dreadlocks are like 6-pack abs. They don't happen overnight. What people don't understand is that when it comes to dreadlocks, there is a journey before you actually get to the lock stage. Us as human beings, we go to fast food restaurant because we want our food like that. We send text messages because we expect somebody to send a message just like that in response. We go to Amazon Prime because we want our delivery in 2 days. And all of that is just leading our culture into shaping up into a world where we want instant gratification. We as human beings forgot the feeling of how it is to be patient, how it is to wait. But no matter how fast paced the world is, when it comes to dreadlocks, you're always gonna have to wait. Now, what I eventually did about this mistake is I stayed humble and I just learned patience. It took my dreadlocks approximately 12 to 14 months to finally lock. And boy, did that humble me. I did not know it was gonna take my locks to take that long, but if you can take a look at my locks now, they're fully mature and they're fully locked up. And I do not regret it, man. So if you're in the process and if you're just impatient, just, yo, wait it out a little bit more. Your dreadlocks will come to mature. Your dreadlocks will look exactly how you want them, man. And you're gonna appreciate yourself. You're gonna thank yourself. You're gonna love yourself because you did what you needed to do to get your dreadlocks to where it wants to be. What I did to overcome this mistake is that I just didn't let myself get discouraged, man. I kept talking to myself. I kept believing in myself. I kept believing in my dreads. I kept believing in my loctician. I kept saying to myself, like, yo, no matter how frizzy it gets, no matter how much it seems like it's not growing, no matter how long it seems like it's not budding up or maturing, I'm going to get there, man. Because that's when I started asking other people, like, yo, how long did it take your dreads to lock up? How long did it take yours? It took my locks 12 to 13, 14 months for it to finally lock up. And then when it did, I am so appreciative to myself that I did. So, fellas, women, don't get discouraged, man. The locks are gonna come, they're gonna form, and when it does, man, you're gonna look back at this video like, man, he was right. he was right. The second mistake that I endured when it came to my dreadlock journey was expecting my dreadlocks to look like somebody else, all right? When I started my dreadlocks, I wanted my dreadlocks to look like Lil Wayne. I put Lil Wayne's dreadlocks as the pedestal of all dreadlocks, man. But I started becoming envious because my dreadlocks look nothing like his. So it created this vicious cycle where I just didn't appreciate of what I had within myself. In the end of the day, my journey is my journey. Nobody can take that away from that. Nobody can take away my experience. Nobody can take away my knowledge, my wisdom. I got that all up in here. And what I did to overcome this mistake is I had to start loving myself. I had to start treating myself right. I had to start appreciating each and every individual locks. I used to real live go in front of the mirror and just say to myself, God dang, boy, look at them locks. They growing. Even if I couldn't even tell they was growing, I looked at my locks every day and I manifested like, yo, my locks are growing. My locks are maturing. My locks looks perfect. Affirmations. You got to say these things to yourself. You got to love yourself. So even though I was comparing my locks to somebody else, I started appreciating my locks because, yo, in the end of the day, there ain't nobody else with my DNA and there ain't nobody else like me. So appreciate yourself. Stop comparing your dreadlock to anybody else. Love what you got right now and trust me. You're gonna have other people looking at your locks and like, dang, I wish my locks were like his. And when you get to that point, it's a good humbling experience. And then you can start creating YouTube videos and asking everybody to hit the like button. Hit the like button. The third mistake I did when it came to my dreadlock journey was using the wrong products. What products specifically? Beeswax. Now, I preach about beeswax, how we shouldn't use it, we shouldn't own it, we shouldn't buy it, we shouldn't invest into it. But honestly, yo, I'm gonna be honest. When I first started my dreadlock journey, that's all I used to use. Beeswax was nice and thick and shiny, man, and it just made your dreadlocks stand out from others. But throughout time, I realized this wasn't the move. But throughout time, I started realizing like, yo, man, it's a lot of buildup. It's a lot of gunk in my dreadlocks. I would wear a do-rag or a bonnet right before I go to bed, and even though I wore something while I was sleeping, it would leave so much residue and so much gunk on my pillows and on my sheets. Just imagine if you slept over a girl's house and you wake up and she has white pillowcases and you got black smudges all in her pillow. She gonna look at you like, wow, your face is dirty. Trust me, I've had that happen before. That's another story. But further ado, beeswax, wrong products for your hair, especially if you are a black person. You should be not using wax at all. It's just not made for us. It's not made for us at all. So what I did to make up for this mistake was I just stopped using beeswax, man. I was so scared and afraid to use beeswax at all. I started asking around. I started doing my information. I started looking things up and I realized, yo, gel is the way to go. All I've been using is gel. And I preach to you guys, please do not use beeswax. I can make a whole video about the experiences that I had with beeswax, man, and it would be funny as hell. If you guys want that, let me know in the comment box down below. You actually want me to give you the experience, the story that what happened when I was in that girl's room and, you know, I woke up with all that beeswax on the sheets? Let me know. I'll speak about that. But, yo, just do not use beeswax at all. Use gel instead. I made plenty of videos about that. So my third mistake was using the wrong product. There's a lot more other products, but I feel like beeswax is the main product that people use that they just don't know too much about. Yo, don't use it. Use gel instead. I made plenty of videos about it. That's my third mistake. All right, now the fourth mistake that I made when it came to my dreadlock journey was actually going to bed with my dreadlocks still wet. Not knowing that with dreadlocks, it takes a lot more time to dry rather than straight hair. Now, this is one of the worst things that you can do to your dreadlocks because it can leave so much mold into your locks. That's right. Mold can grow into your locks and you don't want to have no funky dreads. You don't want to have no bacteria in your dreadlocks. You don't want none of that. So what to do to get away from this mistake is to actually, when you do wash your hair earlier throughout the day so you have the rest of the day to dry. I used to shampoo my hair at night and then expect my hair to be dried in what, an hour or so? Nah, it's going to take time. So if you can shampoo your hair way before it's time for you to go to bed, preferably, you know, during the morning, you have the rest of the day to dry out your hair. You go outside, you get some of that sun, you get some of that nature. It will dry out your hair rather than you just expecting your hair to be dry right before you go to bed. So So do avoid washing the hair at night. Understand if you have to do it, you have to do it, but understand that it can create mold and you do not want that in your dreadlocks. Now, the fifth and final mistake that I did on my dreadlock journey was getting my hair done way too often, styling it all the time, which created so much tension because it was so tight. Getting my dreadlocks retwisted all the time because I wanted to look fresh. This was one of the biggest mistakes that I did with my dreadlock journey. Now, if you do this too often, your hairline will start to recede. You might start balding, you know, you're breaking out the hair follicles in your scalp. Too much tension to your scalp is just not a good thing. It will cause so much breakage and it will prevent your hair to grow. Now, you see, back in the day, it was all about appearance for me. I wanted my dreadlocks to look good because if my hair looked good, I felt like I looked good. But it did so much damage in the long run, I started noticing my dreadlocks started to thin out, but I got it fixed. That's for another video at another time. A way that you can overcome this mistake is to avoid getting your dreadlocks retwisted all the time. I used to get mine done, like I said, every 2 to 3 weeks. Yo, wait a good 6 to 8 to 10 weeks. Now, these days, I only get my dreadlocks retwisted every 2 months. That's about 8 weeks. I give my scalp some time to breathe, and that's just the best way to go about it. You have to understand that you need strong roots to grow strong dreads. You want them to be thick. You don't want them to be thinning out. So avoid getting your dreadlocks retwisted all the time, especially when you first start your dreadlocks. They're going to be nice and thick and so full. You'll appreciate it. And just like that, folks, those were my 5 mistakes that I made with my dreadlock journey. I hope you guys learned something. I hope you guys got some value from this video. Let me know down below in the comment box what mistakes that you guys went through. I would love to know. I read every single comment out there and I reply to every single comment. That's just what I do. I hope you guys have a great day. I hope you guys stay abundant, meditate, stay blessed. And without further ado, my name is Vinny Matthews, and I'm out.